Kids, today we will study science, okay? And we will study the third chapter of science. The name of the chapter is Animals That Help Us. We will study about the animals that help us in various ways, okay? There are different kinds of animals that help us, yes or no? Some animals, they live in forest and jungle. Some animals, we domesticate them. Then some animals we keep those animals at our home with us, yes or no? So today we will study about the animals that help us. What are the different animals that help us? Okay, so kids, we will study about the domestic animals, okay, and how these domestic animals help us. Then what are the different animals that help us in many ways? These animals, they help us in many ways. And what are the different ways these animals help us? We will begin with the domestic animals first. You know what is domestic animals? Domestic animals are those animals whom we keep in our farm. Domesticated animals are those animals whom we keep in our farm, and they gives us milk, food, okay, many different things which these animals provide. These animals are called as domesticated animals. We domesticate animals to get food, to get wool. They give us milk. Understood? So these are the domestic animals. And animals help us in many ways. How do these animals help us? These animals also help us in many ways. So let us read out, let us see, okay? Look, student, I will read out about animals, okay? What it is written in the slide, see? There are different types of animals in the world. Yes or no? There are many different types of animals you see around. Those are like cow, goat, buffalo, horses, sheep, hen, lion, tiger, elephant, monkeys, bear. So many kinds of different animals are there. Yes or no? And some lives in jungle. Which animals lives in jungle? The wild animals lives in jungle. Yes or no? Like lion, tiger, elephant, deer, bear. Yes or no? Then monkeys, where do they live? They live in jungles. Okay. Then some are kept at homes and farm. And some animals, we keep them at home and in farm. What do you mean by farm? Farm is a place where animals are kept, which gives us useful products like milk. Then we get wool from sheep. Yes or no? These kinds of animals are kept in farms, like horses, then buffaloes, then cows. These are kept in farms. Yes or no? And some animals, they live in jungles. The wild animals, they live in jungle. And some animals, we keep them at home. Which animals do we keep at home? We keep cat, dogs, hen, buffalo. Yes or no? Not at home. Hens are not kept at home. They are also kept in farm. But like dogs, then cats, then parrot, rabbit. These are some animals which are kept at home. We pet them, yes or no? Those are called as pet animals whom we keep at home along with us. They stay at home, yes or no? And some are kept at homes and farms. Like farms animals are what? Those are cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, horses. These are some animals which are kept in farm. And some animals who live in jungles are the wild animals, like lion, tiger, then monkey, then bear. Can you see the picture? You can see. These are some animals who live in jungles domestic animals? I told you, what are domestic animals? The animals, I will read out, see, in the slide. The animals that can be kept at farms or homes are called domesticate animals. The animals that we can keep them at home or in the farm, those are called as domesticate animals. And these animals do not harm us. They help us. Okay, they provide us with useful things. The animals that we domesticate are not wild animals. Wild animals can eat us also. They may harm us. Okay, but these domesticate animals, they do not harm us. We can keep these domesticate animals at home and in the farms. Why? Because they give us some useful products. Okay, see, animals like cow, hens, horses, goat, sheep, ducks can be tamed and kept at farms or homes. The animals like cow, we domesticate cow. Why do we domesticate cow? We domesticate cow to get milk. Yes or no? Then hens, we domesticate hens to get meat and egg. Then horses help us in doing various work. They can carry the load also to travel from one place to another. Yes or no? Then goats. What does goat give us? Goat gives us milk also, and they also give us meat. Then sheep. What does sheep give us? Sheep gives us wool. Yes or no? The woolen clothes that we wear, those are made from the wool of the sheep. Okay, then ducks. What does this ducks give us? This ducks also gives us egg, and they are tamed and kept at farms or home. And where are these animals are kept? These domestic animals are kept in the farms and homes. What do you mean by farm? Farm is a place where these animals are kept. Where these animals live, those are called as farm. The place is called as farm. Okay, then what do you mean by tamed? T-A-M-E-D. What is the meaning of tamed? Tamed means an animal that has been trained to live with people. Taming animal. See, the spelling is written there. T-A-M-E-D. What do you mean by tamed? Tamed means it is the animals, the training that we give to animals so that they can live with us. Animals are not like us, yes or no? So we have to give training to the animals so that they can live with us. That is called as taming animals. Understood? Then where do these hens live? These hens, they live in coop. The place where hens live, it is called as coop. C-O-O-P, coop. It is a place where hens live. Then cow. Where does this cow live? Cow live in the shed. S-H-E-D, shed. The place where cow live is called as shed. And where do horses live? These horses live in the stable. S-T-A-B-L-E. Home of a horse is named as stable. S-T-A-B-L-E, stable. Okay. Now see students, these are some animals and their homes. Can you see? First one, hen. That is the home of animals. See, hen, they live in coop. Small, small houses. It is made for hen to live. Where does hen live? Hen live in coop. C-O-O-P, coop. And where do pig live? rivers. Ponds also live in, fish also lives in aquarium. Aquarium is a place at home where fish lives. It is a kind of a glass, okay, where fish are kept in it. Aquarium, it is made of glass where fish, tiny small fishes are, fishes can live in the aquarium. It is written there, aquarium. See, the spelling of aquarium is A-Q-U-A-R-I-U-M, aquarium. The fishes that we domesticate at home, inside home, that is called as aquarium. A-Q-U-A-R-I-U-M, aquarium. Okay, and where do this spider web, spider live? Spider, the home of spider is called as spider web. They build web or not? Have you seen a spider? Yes. Where do they live? They live in the spider web. They build their home of their own. Okay. Then where do these dolphins live? The big, big fishes. Where do they live? They live in the sea. The homes of the big, big fishes is named as sea. S-E-A. Sea. And where do horse live? Horse live in the stable. S-T-A-B-L-E, stable. And cow, they live in shed. S-H-E-D, shed. Okay? So now students, let us read animals that help us in many ways. How animals help us in many ways. Okay? See, first point, we get milk from cows, goats and buffaloes. What does these animals give us? Cows, goats and buffaloes, they give us milk. Okay, then we need milk to grow strong and healthy. And why do we drink milk? We drink milk to grow strong and healthy. It gives us energy. Milk gives us energy. And from where do we get milk? We get milk from cow, goat, buffaloes. Okay, and milk gives us energy to stay strong and healthy. Then milk is used to make things like butter, cheese, ghee, curd and ice cream. What is this milk used to make? It is used to make cheese, then curd, then ghee, ice cream. These are all milk products. These are all made from milk. That is why these are called as milk products. Now what is milk product? Products that are made from milk are called as milk products. Okay. Then we get eggs from birds like hens and ducks. From where do we get egg? We get egg from hens and ducks. That is why we domesticate hens and ducks to get egg from them. Okay. Then we get honey and wax from beehives. You know now what is bee? Bee, this honey are, this the honey that we get, it is extracted from the beehives. We get honey from bee. And the wax that is used to make candles, it is also obtained from the beehive. Bee makes honey. Yes or no? And from bee we get honey. Okay. Then bee wax is used to make candle. The wax that is obtained from bees, beehive, that is used to make candles. Okay, and that is called as bee wax. Then we get meat from animals like goat, sheep, chicken and fish. From where do we get meat? We get meat from animals like goat, sheep, chicken and fish. I will repeat again, okay? Once, we get milk from cows, goats and buffaloes. From where do we get milk? We get milk from cow, goats and buffaloes. And we drink milk to stay strong and healthy. cheese, ghee, curd, ice cream, all these things are made from milk. And the things that are made from milk are called as milk products. And from where do we get eggs? We get eggs from birds like hens and duck. Okay, and honey gives us, and bees gives us what? They gives us honey. Bees make honey in the beehives. From there we get honey. And bee wax is also obtained from bee that we use to make candle. And we get meat from which animals? We get meat from goat, sheep, chicken and fish. These are the animals that gives us meat also. Okay? So students, see the pictures. Can you see? These are the different products that we get from animals. The milk products, see, the like butter, ghee, paneer, milk, curd, ice cream, all these things are what? Milk products. And we get meat from chicken, then fish, yes or no? Then bee. This bee gives us honey. Can you see the picture? Bee gives us honey. And where does this bee makes their honey? What is the home of a bee called? It is called as beehive. Bee lives in beehive where they make honey for us. Okay. So students, now let us study more about animals that help us. Now see, we get silk threads from silkworm. What is silk thread? It is a kind of thread that is used to make clothes. Silk threads are used to make clothes. And these by which those are made into jackets. The skin of those animals are made into jackets, shoes, belts, bag, etc. Okay. See students, these are silkworm. Can you see on the leaves? This silkworm are the insects that weave silk thread. These are the silkworm, and these threads are used to make beautiful silk sarees. Okay, and why do we domesticate sheep? Because to get wool from them. Can you see? The man is shaving the skin of that sheep to get wool. Yes or no? These wool are made from sheep. Okay. And now these leather, see the skin of some animals like tiger, zebra, then different wild animals. Okay, then like buffaloes, crocodiles, snake. The skin of those animals are used to make leathers and beautiful clothes. The skin of the tigers are also used to make different products. Then the skin of crocodiles, snakes, then buffalo, camel. The skin of these animals are used to make leather, and from those they make bags, then belts, shoes. Can you see the picture? Those are some skin of the animals that is used to make leathers and different products. Okay. So now students, more about animals that help us. There are more animals that help us in different ways. Some animals we domesticate to get some useful things from them. Yes or no? And some animals, when they die, we take their skin to make leathers. Then we domesticate some pets at home. And some animals are also used for carrying loads. And when we need to travel from one place to another, some animals also help us. Like, see, I will read out. Animals like oxen, horses, donkeys, elephants, and camels carry heavy loads for us. Yes or no? Some animals like oxen, then horses, donkeys, then elephants, and camels. Why are these animals domesticated for? So that they can carry heavy loads for us. If we want to carry some loads from one place to another, these animals are used to carry our heavy loads from one place to another. The horses are used to carry heavy loads. Then these camels are used to carry heavy loads. The donkeys, you have seen donkeys here carrying heavy loads on them. Yes or no? Then the oxen, these oxen are also used to carry heavy loads. Then some animals helps us to move from one place to another, like horse ride. Horses used to travel from one place to another. Then camel. house. That is why they are called as domesticated animals. Domesticated animals, because they live in the farm that is built outside our houses. And some animals like dogs, then parrot, then rabbits, some animals are domesticated at home inside the house, like cats. Okay, these are some animals that are domesticated inside our inside the house and which live with us inside the house. Those are called as pet animals. And what are the animals like? See, animals like cat, dogs, rabbits and parrots are kept at home. These animals can be kept at home and they can be tamed. Tamed means they can be trained. We can give them training so that they learn to live with us. Okay, so that they don't behave like wild animals. They will learn to live with us. That is why we tame people. Oh, not people, sorry. We tame animals so that they can live with people, like means with us. So that they will not harm us even if they stay with us at home. Okay, then a dog. Why do we pet dog? We pet dog because they guard our house. Yes or no? When there is a dog in your house, he will guard your house. That means no stranger can enter your house. Yes or no? If any stranger will enter your house, what does this dog do? This dog starts barking. If he sees any stranger in your house, what does this dog do? Dog starts barking. Yes or no? So, dog guard our house. Okay. And then a cat chases mice. Hooray! What does this cat do? They chase mice. If there are many rats in your house, this cat, they chase mice and they eat the rat so that there are no rats in your house. And these rats spoil your clothes, they eat the food. Yes or no? So that is why we pet cats at home, so that they can chase the mice. Okay, so students, what did we study today? We studied about the different animals that we domesticate. Yes or no? There are different kinds of animals. Animals that live in jungles and animals that live with us in our homes. What are the animals that live in jungles? Those are wild animals like tiger, lion, elephant, monkey, bear. These are some animals that live in jungles. And what are the animals that live with us? Those are domesticated animals. Domestic animals are those who live in the farms, like cow, buffalo, goats, sheep, horses. Then what are the animals that live with us in our home? Those are dog, cat, rabbit, parrot. Okay, then domestic animals like cow, hens, horses, goats, sheep, ducks can be tamed and kept at farms or homes. And these animals, they live in particular homes. And there are different types of homes of different animals. Like hen, they live in coop. Then pigs, they live in pigsty. The name of the home, the place where pigs live, it is called as pigsty. Then birds, they live in nest. Then frogs, they live in ponds. Fishes also, they live in ponds, lakes, rivers. Yes or no? Then puppy or dog, they live in kennel. Then fishes that we pet at home, they live in aquarium. Then spider, they built their web to live. Those are called as spider web. Then big fishes like dolphin, whales, shark, those live in sea. And horses, they live in kennel. Cow, they live in shed. Okay, and there are different animals with different homes. The name of the homes of different animals are different. Okay, then how does these domestic animals help us? These domesticated animals help us by giving animals also help us in different ways by providing us different things. Like we get silk thread from silkworm, the thread that is used to make clothes like saris and scarves. We get the silk thread from the silkworm. Okay, then we get wool from sheep. To make the woolen clothes, we need wool, and this wool is obtained from the skin of the sheep. Okay, then rabbits also have fur. The fur, the skin of the rabbits are also shaved and used to make wool. Okay, then the skin of animals like snakes, crocodiles, buffaloes and camels. The skin of these animals and different animals like tigers and like different wild animals also, when they die, their skin are used to make leathers and different products. Okay, leather is used to make jackets, shoes, then belts, bag and many more other things. We use leather to make jackets, shoes, bags, belts and many more other things. Then these animals also help us in carrying our load, and we can also travel from one place to another with the help of these animals. Like the animals like camel, donkey, elephants, then oxen, horses, these also carry heavy loads and they also help us to travel from one place to another. That means if we want to move from one place to another, these animals also help us to travel from one place to another. Okay, and what are pets? Pets are animals that we keep in our, that live with us in our home. Example like dogs, then cats, rabbits, parrot. Yes or no? These animals are animals which stay with us in our home. Dog guards our house. That means it guards our house, means it looks after our house. When any stranger enters our house, this dog starts biting, by which we come to know that there is some stranger coming to our house. And these cats, these chase mice. If there are many rats in your home, then these cats they chase the mice and they eat them. Yes or no? So these are some animals that help us in different ways. They provide us food, they help us, they also gives us wool, thread. Yes or no? The skin of some animals are used to make leather. Then some animals help us to carry our load, and they also help us to travel from one place to another. And we also pet animals so that they can live with us. Yes or no? The animals that live with us at home, that we tame, to whom we give the training to live with us, those animals are the leather. Okay, then what are pets? What are pets, students? Pets are the animals that live with us in our home. Pets are animals that live with us in our home. For example, dog, cat, rabbit, parrot, etc. So students, these are some home assignments. You please try to do it yourself. Write it in your copy. Okay? In the next class, I will give you the question and answers of this chapter. Okay, students?